have a treat for you tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, live from Studio A, the queen diva of ballet pop herself, Dato Siti Nurhaliza.
Once in a lifetime, an angel sweeps you off your feet, and everything I'm about disappears before my eyes.
English album, All Your Love, and here she is with us.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me.
It is a pleasure and honor to have you here with us. And the last time we saw you was at the Countdown show.
Yes.
We managed to get a picture, Anlai and I.
Yeah. I know, we were all very excited. We boasted to each other. See, I got a photo with Siti Nurhaliza.
And I said, I was so happy.
I see his face.
But anyway, you know, it's been 20 years, you know, you've been in the spotlight, and that is an amazing journey for any artist. So congratulations.
Thank you so much. Actually, I'm so blessed because I have so many fans that really support me from Singapore. Citizen in Singapore, hi. And of course, from Indonesia and my country, Malaysia. I'm so blessed.
Can I just say something, Siti?
Yes.
You don't look like you've aged one bit at all.
In fact,
you look like the teenager who shot the startup in the 90s.
Yes, we've got evidence. We've got a photo right there. There you go.
Okay.
I think you look better now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, maybe because now I know how to make up, how to dress up. And today I'm doing my own makeup.
You did your own makeup?
Yep.
Wow, that's amazing.
I think you have to teach Yaz how to do it.
She's already beautiful.
Me and Siti Nurhaliza, no comparison.
Anyway, so we know that you've got so many fans here in Singapore. We have some of them in the studio right now.
Yeah. Hi.
But we also have someone who is an entertainer as well.
Yes.
And he is Hyrul Anuar from Suria. Yay! Come on up,
Hyrul.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome. Take a seat.
Oh, next to Siti.
Yes. I'm trembling now, actually.
I know him. Take a deep breath. Okay, so Siti, you've always had all your fans around, and somebody told me that legend has it that when you were born, lots of people from around came to see you.
How do you know?
Oh, a little birdie told us.
Yeah, tell us about that.
Yeah, maybe I mix Bahasa and English, okay?
Yes, please.
Okay, my mother told about that story, and I'm sharing with friends of media. Yes, that's right. During my mother, what, deliver?
Gave birth to you.
Gave birth to me. I live in barrack police.
Yeah, how to? Police barrack.
Police barrack, okay. Balik kan? Okay, because ibu saya melahirkan saya bukan di hospital, di rumah. Dan masa kelahiran saya, ramai yang menantikan untuk melihat. Is it boy or girl? Dan dalam masa tersebut, saya menangis. Ibu saya cerita, saya menangis dengan suara yang tinggi dan panjang. Itu mungkin sign untuk saya jadi singer.
So when her mother gave birth to her, everyone was expecting like to know whether it's a boy or a girl. So apparently, her voice, her pitching was really, really high and it's really long that caught the attention of everybody in the village. Yeah, so everybody just want to get to know who is this baby, who is this baby. So everyone goes to her house lah.
Not like that.
But she was obviously born to be a singer.
Yeah, exactly.
But we also know that your early life was not easy. And at one point in time, you had to go out and help your mom support the family.
Mm-mm. Yes, because my family is big. I have 8 siblings.
Eight
siblings.
Wow.
That's a lot, yeah.
Yeah, then I have to help my mom to sell kuih Melayu, curry pop, pulut udang, cucuk badak. You know cucuk badak?
No, but it sounds delicious.
Badak is actually rhinoceros. Hippopotamus in English.
Yeah. Kuih hippo?
In
Malay, we call cucuk badak, actually.
We need to go and try.
Yes.
Okay, you have to try. And then I still in Pasar Malam, my school, and during Ramadan, I also help my mom to sell all the kuih Melayu with my auntie, semua. So that's really beautiful and meaningful experience for me because I have to be independent, to be responsible.
Responsible
since I was young.
Right, well, humble beginnings.
Exactly.
You know, we'll get to talk to you more about how you've journeyed in life so far later on.
Exactly.
Yes.
Don't go anywhere because when we come back, Siti will share more about her charity and future plans, and she may also perform one of her biggest hits from her latest album, if we can convince her.
If I beg hard enough, please. Welcome back to the Vibe Show. We have the fabulous diva Dato Siti Nurhaliza in the house.
Now Siti has her own production company, her own skincare range, her own brand of teas, dozens of hit songs, and over 200 awards under her belt. Siti, it sounds like you've got everything.
Oh yeah.
And you know, during your birthday celebration in January this year, you received what you said was the most meaningful gift that touched you. Now, for a woman who has everything, what was this gift? Was it a car? Was it
diamonds? No, just kidding.
Got you fooled.
Yeah, for
me. Just kidding. That's my husband. Okay. Actually, yes, that's the best ever gift for my birthday because my husband and my husband's friends they agreed to give money to flood victims, which is terjadi banjir di Malaysia.
The flood victims.
In Malaysia, Pahang, Kelantan, and also Terengganu. So this is something that I've never forget from my husband and my friends of my husband.
This is worth more than any diamond.
Absolutely.
It's a gift of love, helping others.
And I heard it was quite a princely sum of like 310,000
ringgit
or something.
I'm not sure. That, yeah.
It was a very big sum, yeah. But you and your husband founded a charity, Yayasan Nurjiwa. Nurjiwa Foundation. And tell us about the work that the foundation does.
Okay, after we get married, we set up Yayasan Nurjiwa, which is Yayasan means foundation.
Yeah.
Nurjiwa, take from my name, Nur Siti Nurhaliza, so Nur from my name.
Okay.
Jiwa from my husband's late father.
Okay.
Combine Yayasan Nurjiwa. Okay, Nur means cahaya, light.
Light.
Jiwa means heart.
Oh,
so that's
nice.
It's very
meaningful.
Then we start help people in Malaysia, especially for disaster victims, and also poor people. So until now, I still planning to help people through my Yayasan Nurjiwa.
That is beautiful. Awesome.
Absolutely. You know, as a supporter of underprivileged children, we thought that maybe you would enjoy this. Okay, this is what happened last week. Singapore Airlines gave 300 underprivileged people the chance to fly in a plane for the very first time.
Wow.
And we were there to film it. So let's take a look.
Invited different groups of beneficiaries who are from charities that we support, and they include special needs children from special schools, low-income families that we are counseling and helping, as well as elderly from 1-2-room flat. We selected those who have not taken a flight before in their life, and we really wanted them to have this experience.
This is a very special flight, you know. It's a charity flight, and of course it's an honor, and it's a joy and a privilege to be able to operate this flight, and we want to serve them, and the way we can serve them is to fly them.
This flight, Sheila and myself, we are specially selected just to focus on doing balloon sculptures to give out as a welcome gift for all our special passengers today for SQ88.
We're going to entertain our beneficiaries. We are the elderly and also children. We have ukulele players. I'm also playing the guitar. So we're singing and playing music at the same time.
Well, when I first heard about this charity flight itself, first thing that comes to my mind is it's very meaningful, of course. I mean, what are the chances that we are bringing people on their first flight?
When I first saw the name list, I was like, whoa, this is my cousin.
We have never been rostered for a flight together, but this is the first time, and for something so meaningful, it's
family history for us to remember.
Yeah.
so meaningful. I love that. Now, kudos to Singapore Airlines and, of course, the city for giving to those less fortunate.
Yes, a great way to fly and a great way to give. Well, stay with us. When we come back, Siti talks about her plans for the future. We're also going to try to get her to perform the newest hit from her latest album, Fragment. I'm still trying. I'm still trying. Wish us luck.
See you in a bit.
Powerhouse and philanthropist Dato Siti Nurhaliza.
So, Siti, I know we've been asking all the questions and the fans are like, how come we don't get to ask questions? So, let's hear from them.
Okay, we've got one fan over there.
Hi!
Shoot away!
Okay, hi Siti, I'm Perry. I'd like to ask a question. When will your new album be coming out and what can we expect from it?
Okay, inshallah, good willing. My next album will be coming up, if I'm not mistaken, in June.
This month.
Okay. That was my last year. I did my unplugged concert in Malaysia, and we recorded. That album will be the unplugged concert plus three bonus tracks from my new songs.
Nice.
And I hope, Hyri, you will buy the original.
Yes, of course. Thank you so much.
Lots to look forward to. And we also have a question from a media personality. He just happens to be right next to me. Yes. So, Hyrul, you get to ask a question now.
I have
now.
A question for her. After 20 years being in the industry, what is next for Siti Nurhaliza? Is there any upcoming concerts that you want to do?
Oh, okay. That's a good question because I'm planning, because this year is my special year. I'm celebrating my 20 years in music industry, and I plan for a musical concert in November. And I hope Hyri and both of you will be my guests.
We will.
Oh yes, we totally will. We'll be right there.
Absolutely.
And other things that I would love to do is direct my own music video.
Oh, wow. Mm. Wearing many hats.
Yeah, I'm so looking forward to that. Now, you have a song called Jaga Dia Untukku from the latest album called Fragment.
I like the way you say
it, right?
Jaga Dia Untukku.
Okay, is there a story behind it?
Yes, true story about me. Last 2 years, my husband had an accident in New Zealand. So all the sadness, all the feeling about my husband, about the incident, I sing through this album. Fragment means segala cerita atau perjalanan yang dikongsi bersama.
Fragment means pieces of the stories of a life. Yeah.
Wow.
Awesome.
So, well, Siti, now that you're talking about it, would you please do us the honor of performing that very song? Please, please.
Okay. For you.
What is it?
And for the fans as well.
Untukku from her latest album, Fragment. Give it up for Siti Nurhaliza.
Mahuku bersama, mahuku kesana diriku tapi sini lagi. Waktu tak bicara. Lama terasa seakan terhenti mengiringiku. Tenanglah duhai jiwa, tebalah tulus doaku kepadanya. Saat ku tiada, oh Tuhan, jaga dia untukku. Kala ku masih jauh, bagai menghitung desa berkepingan. Syurga bersama menyayangi hentam.
seribu biar detik menjadi laju, langit pun mendengar. Jadi penawar mengisi debat jatuh ke dasar. Tenanglah duhai jiwa, tibalah tulus doa ku kepada.
To the next 20.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So sweet of you.
Thank you.
Have you on the show, and we hope you'll come back for
Singapore
more often.
Yay.
Thank you.
So, you know, that's all we have for you today. There's no show tomorrow, so you won't be able to watch me on the 5 show, but you can watch me hosting the opening ceremony of the Sea Games happening live tomorrow at 7:30 p.m.
See you next Monday. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.